Hello, good evening viewers, wherever you're watching, you're welcome. My name is Jevik. So wherever you're watching, you're welcome. So there is a topic we're gonna talk today. Please listen to my message and watch my video, please. So the message we are going to address today is message about the marriage couples. So we would like you people to hear out from all this message. So what I'm trying to say today, that many homes are breaking home today because we women's, the way we are putting things is not good for us, you understand? So we need to do something in a way that it will be good for us and in a way that will be good for our partner. So we are going out to say something today. We are addressing some issue in a way it will be good for those that will listen to this message, and I hope this message help you to your home too. I am not trying to tell you that I'm perfect, but this is what I see today that is bringing problem in many homes today, and this not supposed to be taking place. That's why we need to pay attention and correct some error and some mistake in the area we are seeing the things that is happening to our life that we don't like. And I pray that this message will help one or two people in life. So what I'm trying to address today is that the marriage couples, many homes are breaking today and which is not right. So we are going out to pass this message to the both side of two couples, being the man, being the woman, you understand? Because me, I'm also a married woman, you understand, with families. So I am trying to tell, as in the men, because it's in the Bible that man is the head of the family and woman is the heart of the family, you understand? So why I am going to say this, that we women need to give our husband respect in the house, you understand, in the way that things will be okay and things will be good for us, you understand? We are telling the men, being our husbands, they should take proper caring for their wife, because women, they are meant to love. Women, they are meant to take care of. Women, they are meant to support. Women, they are just like a fragile heart. Our hearts is just like, it's very, very fragile. So women, we need love, we need caring, we need petting, we need encouragement. So we are saying that all women, they are one, you understand? There is no need for a man to be cheating in a marriage when you know what you are searching for is still in your home. So we are saying that men should try to value their partner. Valuing your partner is in the way of this. So what we are trying to say, be contented in a woman you have in the house. When you love your woman and you share your problem to your woman, be contented. Don't think woman you marry in the house hiding a problem. Your woman is your friend. The best friend you have today is your partner. And being your partner, you don't have to hide anything for her. You have to let her know what is happening, and she have to let you know what is happening. So we are going to address marriage in this way. As in, marriage is breaking up today, it's from the men, it's from the women. So first of all, we have to address the men's own before we go to the woman. There is no, I don't have to talk much, but what I'm telling you people today is most of the thing that is happening in marriage, because we don't trust ourselves. And into a marriage or into a relationship where there is no trust, there is no love. Because I bet you, if you don't trust this, this don't trust you, it cannot work out for the both of you people. Why? Misunderstanding. You don't tell your partner the secret, you don't tell your partner the truth, you don't tell your partner something when you're supposed to tell your partner. You keep things to yourself. It can't work like that. We need to be truthful. We need to be faithful to ourselves by loving our partner. And I am telling the men, they should try to love their wife in their house. Don't think a wife you have in your house is just a housewife. It's not an ordinary housewife. You feel it's ordinary housewife. The kind of thing she's putting together in a home is more than any other thing. Take example, a woman will take proper care of children. A woman will take proper care of children. They want to go to school. This woman will try her best to put the children in the school. Women will do more, we multiply much love in the home more than any other thing, you understand? When this woman is caring, he's caring for the family. It doesn't mean that a man is when he brought bring money or any other thing, that a woman don't have anything to utter in the house. A woman is doing a lot of things in the house, which you, me and you need to understand. That woman you see, you keep in the house, or she's a housewife, she's not working, she's working. Because if you have somebody that is working what that woman is doing in the house, you will know that your woman is doing something. To take care of children is not easy. To put food in the house, to clean the house is not easy. To wash the clothes is not easy. Women, we are doing a great job, you understand? So you men should try to appreciate your woman in the house. It's not when the woman is doing things you say she's not doing, maybe you feel less concerned. We are there to help one another, you understand? And we are there to love one another. Since you call this woman your woman and you love this woman, you take this woman to the church, you make marriage with this woman, you have to love everything about this woman. Is not you cheating on this woman, doing things that is not good. You a man running outside cannot help you. Your woman is your woman. When you don't see a beauty in this woman, try to develop beauty by yourself. It's not when you see a woman that is flashy outside, you start running upon that woman, going after that woman. It can't help you. Maybe when your woman will find out, this will bring problem in the home. Problem will start, no trust, no love. From there, misunderstanding will come in marriage, and which is not proper. So I am trying to address issue that let men appreciate what they have in house. When your woman is not flashy the way you want it, make that woman to be flashy. Put that woman to your own proper position. Put her in the way, in the taste you want this woman to be. Running outside to go and look for side chick or to do this, it can't help you. Rather, this side chick will bring a problem into your home. Do you know a married man, when you are mixing with different kind of women, this kind of women, let me tell you, women, they are just like I don't know what to say, you understand? Meeting different kind of woman in your life, you are still damaging the root of your life, but you don't know, because that is kind of woman you will meet, associate with, he will bring you to zero setback, you understand? Maybe the step of the setback you have is limit. When this woman comes to your life, 100% setback will come into your life. You will start looking for what is your problem, what is happening to your life, but you don't know you are the cause of your problem. So I am trying to tell men today that be contented with the woman you have in your house. Love your woman, care for your woman, shelter your woman, feed your woman, clothe your woman, present your woman the way you want her to present herself. If the way she's presenting herself you don't like it, tell her, woman, this is the way I want you to look like. Show her example so that she can be able to follow that route. You searching for a glittering side chick cannot help you. Rather, to bring home back, to break home, to bring quarrel in the house, to bring scatter in the house. So I am trying to tell you, when you see a side chick that is flashy outside and you have a woman at home, please, that thing you see in that side chick that is attracting you, try to develop it in the one you have in the home. We women, we are just one. Just if you need a beauty, it's just a matter of time to develop your own interest in it. The beauty or the interest of what you need from your woman will come out. Every woman is beauty. Every woman is beautiful. There is no woman that is beauty than other. You understand? All depends the way you present yourself. All the way depends how you showcase yourself. I am telling you this today. I am a woman. I am a family woman with 3 kids. You understand? It doesn't mean because I am a woman with 3 kids that I should look tattered, that I should look... No, I have to be okay where my husband will see me and be okay, because these days we are. Men go for flashy things now, because what is happening before is not what is happening now. Because what I'm telling you, if you are not the type that position yourself in the way your husband wants, please ask your husband to show you how he wants you to look like. And when he show you that, try to take a step and follow what he wants. And I'm still begging the men out there, you understand? Cheating cannot help you. Develop love. Show love to your partner. Show caring to him. Present gift for him. Women are their flower. They need shelter. They need presence. They need love. They need to take out the kind of place they want. You are the one to expose your wife, to show her the kind of look you want her to look. Don't let any other woman to be flasher than your own woman. Don't see a woman and you feel that this woman is better than your woman. No. Be proud of the woman you have. Good or bad, be contented with your partner. Love your partner. Cherish your partner. And we women today, I am advising you people, those that is checking after going after their husband, checking their husband telephone, checking the message, checking the Facebook, checking the Twitter, checking the Instagram, this cannot help us. Rather, he will bring a breakage in the home. You understand? I am trying to tell you, if you are the woman who has a caring husband who cares for you and shelter you, take care of you and your children and your kids, give you everything you want, clothe you, put food on the table for you, you being the housewife, you have to embrace this your husband. Show him love. Whenever he's around you, show him love. Don't feel so pompous. Don't feel anyhow. You are the one to make him feel. Whenever he's outside, he's thinking of you. There is no woman that is going left and right that will be flashing. Whenever he's anywhere, he's thinking about you. Your matter is ringing on his head. So I am trying to tell you women today, please, try to love your partner, try to love your husband, try to present your husband, try to present him good in your friend's presence. Don't mind maybe when your friends come and tell you that their husband is like this, is like that. Maybe you are the type that don't marry the rich one, you begin to feel bad, you begin to feel somehow. No, it does. All fingers, they are not equal. When you see that this your friend is trying to bring you in a way that will make you not to like your husband, that will be discouraging your heart, as in you begin to ask, why is my husband not trying? Why is my husband not pushing forward? These friends, they are just deceivers. They want to bring you down. They want to take you out of this marriage. They are not comfortable to themselves and they are not happy for you. You think they are happy for you. They are not happy for you. They are not there to contribute any good thing to you. So you have to focus on you and your family, your children. If you are the type that have children, let your children, your family, let your husband and your children be your friendship. Let them be the people you see, you love. Let them be your good morning and good afternoon. People out there, friends are just there to deceive you. They are there to tell you what is not good in marriage. They are not there to give you good advice. They are there to distract your heart. They are there to fold your heart to pieces. They are not there to contribute any love to you. Once you love your marriage, if your marriage is you are eating, you are not eating, hide yourself inside your house. Stop bringing your family matter outside. Stop selling your husband. Stop selling you yourself outside. Do you think that friends, they care for you? They don't care from you. They just care to listen and hear how they can operate with you. And when they hear from you, they go to their coven. They operate the kind of operation they want to operate. They try to bring your family down. So I am trying to tell you people today, please try to love your husband. Try to relate things to your husband. Try to tell your husband truths. Try to be honest to your partner. You understand? When things is working like this, then you will see love. You understand? There is no need of us lying to our partner, discriminating our husband, feeling that our husband is not trying. If your husband is not trying, put him into prayer. The prayer is for you and God to communicate in your husband, not to share your problem with your friends. Sharing your problem with your friends don't have anything to add in your life, rather to bring you and your husband down, rather to bring you and your children down. They are there, their concern is to hear a news from you. Is it working well? Is it not working well? So that they can know the next target to operate. When things is working well and you give them this answer, they are there to distract this marriage. They are there to destroy this marriage. When you are making a step and you see the kind of friends you are bringing into your life and into your family, into your home, that they are not making any part to you, you have to split these friends out. They have no contribution to your life, rather to add pieces to your life. I really mean it. We married women and married men, let us use our mind. It's not to break for marriage, divorcing marriage, quitting marriage. It can't help us. Do you think that this man, the next step you are going to take, do you think is the best man? When you break out with the original marriage you have and you think making step to the next marriage, the other one, you don't know. They say the devil you know is better than the devil you don't know. You meeting another man, you will still have break up there. Yeah, because you have started from the first person to break up marriage. In the second level you are going, you are still going to break up marriage. If you don't quit that evil spirit that is communicating this breakup, you cannot get away with it. So I am just trying to tell you, my brothers and sisters, marriage couples, please put yourself together. Try to love yourself. Try to let both of you be the best friends. Try to be the best friends to each other. Try to love each other. Try to tell each other truth. Try to show each other whatever you need from your husband, the kind of clothes you want your husband to put that is attracting you outside. Tell your man, honey, this is what I want you to wear. This is what I want you to put on. It's not when you see another man outside, you get attractive and the one, your own husband is nothing to you. No, it's not good. It doesn't work in this way. So all this marriage that is breaking outside, putting home outside, we are the kids and the children, we are the one distracting the children, intelligent, is not good. Because when you dismount a man from this, dismount, break a marriage, the man is one side, the woman is one side, and maybe children are there. My family couples, you people should shake it. It doesn't balance at all. Because these children, they are there, no father caring, no mother caring. Maybe the woman is the one taking care of. It can't work good like this. Let's try to love ourselves. Let's try to unite ourselves. Let's try to stop this marriage breaking up and down. Let's try to stop this divorce up and down. It's not good. Because let me tell you, my brothers and sisters, when you marry and you break up marriage and you are going to the next step of another marriage, it's not a good name. It's a very bad thing. It's a damaged thing. You understand? This woman have married before, she break up and she's going for another marriage. When you marry that one, you break up and maybe from there, different mother, different father. It can't work like that. Let's try to unite ourselves with our partner. Let's try to love our partner. Let's try to show love. Let's try to show appreciation to our partner. You understand? Things will work away in this way. Please, I have not much to say, rather to contribute what I feel. I don't tell you that everything is well with me, but this is the advice I have for the marriage couples out there. Please, I would like when you listen to this, you will use it to learn something in life. So thank you, my brothers and sisters. Love you. Bye bye, and try to watch this my video and like it.